Thus, based on this body of evidence, the committee concludes that the evidence favors rejection of a causal relationship between thimerosal-containing vaccines and autism. This conclusion differs.
Why isn't the scientist saying that vaccines don't cause autism? Why the carefully chosen words? What is he hiding? What do you think he's hiding behind these words? The truth is, he's not hiding anything. He's being honest. Science teaches us that we never know anything with 100% certainty. Never. All we have are degrees of certainty. As good evidence piles up, we become more and more certain. Take gravity, for example. If I let go of this pen, how certain are you that it will fall? 99%? 100%? You might be 100% certain, but a good scientist wouldn't be. Why not? Some strange artifact of physics could rear its head and hold the pen afloat. It sounds unlikely, because it is, and we have seen every pen fall when let go. But just because you've only seen white swans doesn't mean black swans don't exist somewhere out there. The more you look for them, the smaller the chance of black swans existing. The more pens fall, the smaller the chance that the next one won't. But that chance never reaches zero. This scientific concept of degrees of certainty definitely applies to vaccines and whether or not they cause autism. As more and more studies have come in, we've become more and more certain that vaccines are not associated with a higher risk of developing autism. We can add to the pile that famous paper by Andrew Wakefield, who can no longer practice medicine in the United Kingdom because he acted irresponsibly and dishonestly. You know, by recruiting children at his son's birthday party and drawing their blood without ethics approval and conducting experiments without controls. And oh yeah, by being paid up front by a lawyer who wanted to sue vaccine manufacturers. The evidence will never pile up to hit that 100% mark. Never. We are never 100% certain in science. That's why official bodies will say, we have found no evidence, no relationship. We reject a causal relationship. Not because deep down inside they know there's a link, but they're hiding it. They're just being intellectually honest. Based on the data that we have, there is no evidence for an association between vaccination and autism. This is how scientists speak. Next time you feel like saying you're absolutely sure of something, take a page from the science handbook. It's all about degrees of certainty. Oh yeah, and black swans exist. I know that. Don't write to me in the comments.